that tower.
Can't understand why you don't just give up on helping things. Says you should take it easy. Amazed you haven't met Noko. She's the best. So kind to critters of all sorts. Says you'll see each other later. Says you should be careful when heading out. There's been trouble with wastelanders recently. Says you're welcome back. Word is the Northwest World. It's a rare sight. Treasure it. Wildlife here is teetering on the brink of extinction. We all are. Meat-eater again. Nothing seems to satiate his hunger. The note is done for unless you intervene. fool. Hey, nice shot. It's a fine way to ride. Might want to hold your breath before you head any further. You're about to witness the breathtaking The Village of Blubbermud, which is maybe as messy as it sounds. Let's see. Asks you to check out the wares, confident you'll find everything you need here. Says you'll see each other later. Try to be friends with the beast. That over there is Steepo Depot, the cliffside that Moog hangs on to. Save your energy. One hand after the other.
But see, in more.
Let's see. This one's impressed to see you out here. He figured you'd be dead by now. Not many are as tough and clever as you must be. Claims he goes after the most dangerous game, huge monsters. Moog says that all your power doesn't do you a bit of good if you're not willing to pull the trigger when the time comes. Choosing what to kill and what to spare are the most important decisions you'll make. You might have a steady aim, but you need to be sure that you pick your targets with care. It's hard to make those life or death decisions for others, but someone's got to do it. Otherwise, they'll do it themselves and you know they'll miss. When it comes to monsters, he mostly picks who dies. Worries that when the world dies, there won't be any monsters left. What will he shoot then? Wonders why you work so hard to keep things alive. Bullets help thin the herd instead. Approves of you working with the Jagni. They have the hunting spirits of a flock of hawks. Mostly they don't actually hunt. They just help spot monsters for him. But enough of that, right? He says the wildlife, nature, has changed and turned against us. Instincts of survival took over when the world changed.
dear.
He's not sure about their veggie diet anymore, and if it's changed, who knows what it's done with the chemical composition of their body output. Right now, though, he feels he's come to a point where he's got a pretty clear idea on the whereabouts of monsters, both tall and short. Says as big as they are, the world is bigger. To find where they are, you need to see where they've been. Moog says you must learn to walk before you can run. It takes practice before you can call yourself a monster hunter. Fortunately for you, he can help. He understands you need to start off with something small before you go big. There's no better place to start than a Sqvip cave. Hunting down a couple of these little critters for yourself should keep you on your toes. Says you stick to the haunting and shots present themselves later. Everything looks stunted round here. A death worthy of little lives here. Feels lonely here. Even the air is gone. Your ears just pooped. Better perk your ears up. Darkness doesn't hurt sound. Put one robot foot in front of the other. Wait, it's the Sqvip hole-up. Place is just filled with critters.